Let's start with the static routing. In this firmware, we have introduced the possibility to configure static routing. This feature is available in the network setup page, static routing. Static routing is especially useful in cases like network segmentation, which is when the network to scan is divided into multiple subnets, or multiple network gateways, which is when choosing a gateway or another may lead to different scan results depending on the devices that can be found on the path between the penetrator and the targets, for example a firewall. In this page, a list of the existing static routings is shown, and to add a new one, you should enter the target network or IP address, and then the gateway. The gateway can either be an IP address or a network card among the cards that are available on the penetrator, with the exception of ETH0, which is the default network card. Enter the gateway, a description if you want, and then press plus. When you create or delete a static routing, this has immediate effect on the system and can influence both scheduled and ongoing scans. To create a new static routing with an IP address as gateway, enter the network or IP address and the gateway, and that's it. If you are configuring a static routing for the network through which you are connecting to the penetrator, you must be careful because you may lose access to the web interface if the configuration that you are doing is not correct. You cannot create multiple routings for the same network. When you try to do so, it will trigger an error. However, you can configure a static routing for one of the IP addresses of an existing routing. For example, this IP address is included in this network and is using a different routing. Static routing is used by another feature that we have added to this firmware of the penetrator, which is the selection of the network card for scanning. In fact, if a particular target or subnet to scan is connected through a penetrator's network adapter different from the default one, it is now possible to specify that immediately before starting a scan. For example, let's start a new scan. This feature is available in the Advanced Settings page of a scan. After entering the list of the scan targets and the scan profile, click on Advanced Settings at the lower right corner of the page. In the next page, click on Advanced Setup. Then, in the page with the list of the advanced feature, locate Network Card or Gateway and select the routing of your choice. The list will show all the available network adapters and all the gateway IPs that have been configured in the static routing page. When a different network card or gateway has been selected, the system will create a new static routing for the scan target through the selected network card or gateway. This static routing will remain active from this moment onwards, even after the scan has been completed. As this is a system-level feature, it will also affect all the other scans performed in the system. Also here, if a static routing for the scan target already exists, an error message will appear, and in this case, if you want to change the network adapter or gateway for the current target, you should open the static routing page and delete the old routing.